Hey, welcome back to day 9 of the Plankathon. I'm George Anderson, and I am so pleased that you've come back after 8 days, including twice around with a Max Plank Accumulator, and you're still here. You know what? If you've got this far, I have every confidence that you're going to make it right the way through to the end. Everybody who is going to quit the program has probably quit at this point, but you're still here, so kudos to you, and thanks for sticking with it. Today, we are going back to our 30-30-30 sequence, where we do a 30-second exercise, plank-based, of course, then a 30-second static hold plank, and a 30-second rest, and we'll be doing a bit of a stretch out in the 30 seconds as well. There's 4 rounds of this, gives us 5.5 solid minutes of work. The exercise today is a real goodie. It's the knee crosses. We're going to do this from the high plank position, or aka the press-up position. So we're going to start from here, and I'm going to get you to bring your knee through across to the opposite elbow. Now, it doesn't have to touch, but that's kind of what we're aiming for. And if you're too far back, you've got no hope. If you can bring the shoulders forwards, you'll probably find that it just about contacts the elbow, knee to elbow. So we're going to try and do this with as much stability as we can. There's a good bit of upper body work in here. Your shoulders are definitely going to be having a major part to play in this workout, as well as the core. You're working the obliques with that lovely twisting movement, and then we're going to go down and smash out a 30-second plank with all the usual trimmings and options as per the last few workouts. 30 seconds of rest we'll be doing, as I said, a stretch sequence. So, 4 rounds of this. If you're ready, we're going to go in 2, 1. Here we go now. Knee to the opposite elbow. I am going to give you the options in the next round, because I tell you, there's some really, really funky different options we can do. And I can also tell you, there won't be much chat from me when we're doing them, because they are hard. But this is fine. Pause to regress it. Pause for a little longer in between, then bring it through. You can even just reduce the range of movement. That's fine as well. There's your 30 seconds. Drop down into plank and just hold it there. Tailbone tucks under. You're holding that strong plank position, pushing down through the forearms and the toes. The knees down is now a valid option. We're not doing the MPA now. You can rest, or not rest, sorry. You can rest, but actually I'd rather you just drop to half plank. You can stick with it. Stay right up here on your toes. For 2, 1, and rest out there. Okay, the stretch this time, I want you to come up to all fours, bring your knees apart a little bit, and just sink back into this child's pose. Just allow yourself to drop in there. Hold. Wiggle your fingers forwards and your bottom back. You can get a lovely stretch through the back there. 10 seconds to go. Come back up again. Just a quick cat-cow sequence. Arch the back. Push the bum to the rear. Remember that from the other day? Alrighty, let's get back in again. Round 2 of 4. Knees across. So we can start getting a bit more moving. A little bit quicker with this. You can actually jump from one foot to the other. But you've got to make sure that the shoulders are forwards. If you're too far back, you're never going to get the knee to touch the elbow. Bring it forwards. You're going to make that contact, no problemo. It does make it more challenging in the shoulders. But hey, you're not here for an easy ride, right? You made it to day 9. That tells me something about you. We can have some fun here. Drop it down to plank for 30 seconds. Okay, options. We talked about the knee down regression. How about we take that back to the lengthened plank? The uber luxury plank. Or we can experiment again with just playing around with that knee, that foot tap. A couple of inches off the ground. No movement in the rest of the body, but feel how it changes the forces going on through the core just by lifting one foot off the ground and rest. Halfway through. See, it's not that bad, is it? Let's get a child's pose. Stretch and drop. Woof. There we go. Feels good. Feels good. Come back up again. And let's just have that little cat-cow sequence there. Arching the back and pushing the bum to the rear. This next round, this is where my chat reduces significantly, because we're going to go with a luxury option like you've never seen it before. Let's just set it up first of all. We're going to go with the knee coming across. There's your base. A little quicker if you want to. Or take it out to a full leg under. Now as you come through here, I'm trying to do this without touching my foot to the ground. There's the final position. knee is off the ground, foot is off the ground. Coming through, through we go. A lot more strength in the upper body in this one, and back down to plank. Hold it there. Okay, dig in now. We've got one more round to go, which means one more minute after this 20 second remaining plank. Pushing down, just toughen it out here. I'm not gonna be doing the luxury plank option here because I've got one more advanced version to show you in the final round of that last workout, that last exercise with the knee crosses. 3, 2, 1. Oof, knees down. Bring that back to child's pose. Stretch it out. 30 seconds of rest. Really nice stretch. Just wiggle those fingers forwards. Sending the tailbone back and down. And then come back up again. Cat cow. Arch the back. Lift it up. Here we go. Last time. Are you ready for this? Use your options. Don't compromise your form. But if you feel like it, you're ready for it, you're ready for a challenge, then let's go. Swing those legs through. Dropping the hip, but keeping the foot off the ground. 30 seconds of work. Then we're going to drop in to plank. I'm going to shut up. And just groan and grunt my way through the rest of this workout. 7 seconds. Go. Oh, it's tough. 2, 1. Down to plank. Woo. Oh my goodness. Now I'm feeling it. Now it's hurting. Now I'm gritting my teeth here, really digging deep, trying to make sure I keep my tailbone tucked right under. You know, I don't want to let my hips sag down or rise up. I want to keep it straight and flat. Come on, we're in this together. Last few seconds. 3, 2, 1, and rest. That there. Oh my word. That is a tough one. Oh, I'll tell you, we're gonna have about that tomorrow. This isn't just about taking the hardest option available. There's many more ways to make it even that harder, but it's about making it harder for you relative to what you can do. Just challenging your own beliefs about your limits. Every workout gives you an opportunity to do that. Maybe you do it for one rep or two reps. Maybe you do it for the whole thing, but challenge yourself. Keep this going. We've only got a few days left to go now. I'm so pleased you're still with me. I'll see you back here tomorrow. Bye for now.